fun by day, wait until you see it by night.
Welcome to a night at Walt Disney World with the Mike Douglas Show. And now, here's the star of the show, Mike Douglas.
Love, love will keep us together. Think of me, babe, forever. Some sweet talking guy comes along, singing his song. Don't mess around or you gotta be strong. Stop, cause I really love you. Stop, I'll be thinking of you. Look in my heart and let love keep us together. You belong to me now. Ain't gonna set you free now. When those guys start hanging around, talking me down, here with your heart and not with your sound. Stop, cause I really love you. Stop, I'll be thinking of you. Look in my heart and let love keep us together. Or whatever. Young and beautiful, someday your looks will be gone. When somebody's turning you off, who'll be turning you on? I will be there to share forever. Love's gonna keep us together. I said it before and I'll say it again. I'll fight with the end. I need you now. I can't see the cards, so stop. I really love you. Stop. I'll be thinking of you. Look in my heart and let love. Look in these lights, I go blind. Look in my heart and let love keep us together.
How about this great band, ladies and gentlemen? Joe Massamino and the guys. Woo! Take a bow, Joseph. I didn't recognize you all dressed up. Welcome. It's nice to have you here on such a balmy, lovely evening. Just had my orange juice and I'm ready to cook. When I think of Florida, I think of things like sunshine. I think of things like suntan, healthy faces. I think of orange juice, I really do. And I think of my co-hostess, and I know that you do too. And here she is doing her brand new single recording, Miss Anita Bryant.
I gave me an old-fashioned church in an old-fashioned town, and an old-fashioned preacher man is saying, what this world really needs is lots of love and good deeds and a whole lot of old-fashioned praying. Give me an old-fashioned choir and an old-fashioned hymn and an old-fashioned organ player playing. And even broken-down keys and even broken-down knees shouldn't stop you from old-fashioned praying. On a hill far away has an old-fashioned way of getting to you. And old rafters sway when the people do in some old-fashioned way.
Is that lovely?
Woo!
Oh, that's a nice song.
Thank you.
That's your record?
Yeah. My new single.
Isn't that a nice record?
Thank you very much. Oh, they're a nice audience.
Oh, are they ever?
Oh.
That's because they're all hot and ready to go,
they
boy.
Sure
they're
are.
Ready to cook.
Oh, isn't this beautiful?
This is wow. Is that gorgeous?
I am
don't
so
you think,
excited
don't
to be on this
like
stage.
Don't you feel like you died and went to heaven, though, or something?
Yes.
I have a feeling. Maybe I did. I've died a lot on this show, folks. About 3 out of 5 times a week, I do it. Our first guest is not only a favorite of television fans, but also movie fans. In fact, he has done 9 pictures for Walt Disney Productions, including his current called Blackbeard's Ghost. I almost said Bluebeard's. It's Blackbeard's Ghost. And on top of all that, he really is a nice guy.
He sure is.
We have grown to really enjoy him and like him these past few days. And I want a warm welcome for Mr. Dean Jones. Here he is.
It's been so great out here the last couple of days. I want to thank Mike and his wife, Jen, Anita, her husband, Bob. And a couple of days ago, Mike sang a song to his wife. And Mike, with your permission and yours, Jen, I'd like to sing this song to my wife, Laurie. For once in my life, I have someone who needs me, someone I've needed so long. For once unafraid, I can go where life leads me. Somehow I know I'll be strong. For once I can touch what my heart used to dream of, long before I knew someone warm like you could make my dream come true. For once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me, not like it's hurt me before. For once I have someone I know won't desert me, I'm not alone anymore. For once I can say, this is mine, you can't take it. Long as I know I have love, I can make it. For once in my life, somebody needs me. For once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me, not like it's hurt me before. For once I have someone I know won't desert me, I'm not alone anymore. For once I can say, this is mine, you can't take it. Long as I know I have love, I can make it. For once in my life, somebody's heard my plea. For once in my life, I have someone.
You went for the big ending, the $20 note. At these prices, Dean, that's fabulous.
You know, I don't believe this. I mean, I have seen so many of your movies. All of our kids, we just see nothing but Disney World movies, 1001 Dalmatians. You're a wonderful actor, but I had no idea what a great singer you were. I mean, well, I just...
Where do you hide when you're not working? You don't know he sings?
Well, no, not like that.
I don't do much. I don't do much singing.
Oh, just kidding. Fantastic.
Can I tell you a few other things, big items?
Well, sure.
The Pope is Catholic.
Oh. Anyway.
Moses was Jewish.
Well, what I'm trying to do, Mike, is get him to sing along with us. I mean, you know. Isn't
Wait,
that a
Dean,
good idea?
Where are you going? Was there something we
well,
said?
Well, he could use a mic if he's going to sing with. And as a matter of fact, we're here in this beautiful setting.
Okay.
And what would be more fitting
the lady in the middle.
Than, well, I mean, a song like this. And the lyrics are very simple.
Okay.
And you think you can handle
heavens.
It?
I hope
and,
I can.
Well, if not, just look at the cue cards, okay?
Two syllables, I'm in trouble.
Here we go.
Bob and Dick Sherman wrote this.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Um-diddle-little-little-um-diddle-lie.
Because I was afraid to speak when I was just a lad. Me father gave me nose a tweak and told me I was bad. But then one day he learned a word that saved my aching nose, the biggest word you ever heard, and this is how it goes.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Um-diddle-little-little-um-diddle-lie.
Traveled all around the world and everywhere he went, he'd use this word and all would say, "There goes a clever gent." When dukes and maharajas pass the time of day with me, I spy me special word and then they ask me out to tea. Orange juice.
Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
So when the cat has got your tongue, there's no need for dismay. Just summon up this word and then you've got a lot to say.
Oh, very good.
But better use it carefully or it may change your life. One night I said it to me girl and now me girl's me wife. I got it. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
We'll be right back right after the, I get my face massaged.
A lot of you moms don't know there's a lot of good inside Kellogg's Pop-Tarts toaster pastries.
There is?
Sure. First of all, there are 6 Pop-Tarts inside.
6? That's good.
And there's real fruit filling inside, plus a tasty pastry crust.
Hey, that's good, Milton.
And 6 vitamins and iron.
Well, now that's very good.
You see? For snacks, or as part of a good breakfast, it's good to know there's a lot of good inside Kellogg's Pop-Tarts.
I'm Johnny Rutherford, and I've won an Indy. But I've got to go to work just like everybody else. You may know me for auto racing, but the Yellow Pages has helped make me famous for bikes. My motorcycle dealership out here in the suburbs had an identity problem, like any new business. But Yellow Pages helped solve that. Helped put me on the map. You're in business. The Yellow Pages probably help you, too. Who knows? Might even help make you famous.
I'm a nut. I'm a peanut nut. I'm not about crunching much.
Cause there's a fist full of peanuts. In every crunchy bar. Munch.
Munch peanut bar.
Munch peanut bar.
There's a fist full of peanuts.
In every munch.
Can't wait to use my new machine.
Don't use that.
Hey, I need my all-temperature powder.
Use Liquid All. It is all-temperature. Cleans better than your powder.
Let's see. Clean this greasy mess out of a cotton shirt. My powder can't, even in hot water.
Well, no detergent gets out everything, but Liquid All cleans better than the leading all-temperature powder.
Look, it's clean.
So, for cleaning in cold, warm...
or hot, I'll take the better all-temperature detergent, Liquid All.
That's better.
Okay. All this week you've been meeting people who've been closely associated with Walt Disney Productions over the years, and our next guest was 12 years of age when Walt first saw her at a dance recital. He asked her to audition for a new project, which turned out to be the Mickey Mouse Club, and she became one of America's favorite Mouseketeers. And now, a very glamorous young lady. Would you welcome Annette Funicello?
Yeah. you right there.
Is this cold for California? Would this be cold in California?
This sure would be cold in California. You know, I never thought Florida would ever be like this.
Funicello. That's Swedish, isn't it?
No, you know something? My family has always said Funicello. They Americanized it.
Funicello.
Funicello. So when I started working for Mr. Disney, he said, oh, it's such a beautiful Italian name if you pronounce it correctly. And I said, well, what is the correct pronunciation? He said, you have to say Funicello.
It's in three-quarter time. Melodious. The Italians talk in three-quarter time. Funicello, Vecchi Kingdom.
Funicello. You know,
Massimino, Jimmy DiGiulio, Vince Trombetta, Mike Natale, all in my band.
You know, I think the heat's gotten to you, Mike.
I think it is.
Did you know?
No, I...
You know, it's funny.
I'm just trying to keep freezing to death there.
You know,
Annette and I
were on tour with Dick Clark, and we did a lot of things in those days when we both had hit records. That was a long time
ago. Frankie Avalon.
That's right.
It was a long time
ago. Paul Anka.
The last time I think we worked together was at the Hollywood Bowl. We did a Dick Clark special.
That's right.
How long were you a Mouseketeer?
Well, we started the show in 1955, and we only filmed for 2 years, which is surprising to a lot of people because it seemed like it was...
It's back on the air now.
It's back on now. But then they went right into repeats, and so it seemed like it was on for much, much longer than it really was, new shows.
Now, Mr. Disney found you at a dance recital.
Right.
Was there an audition that took place after that?
Yes. After he saw me dance, he called my dancing school and said, would you please bring her to the studio for an audition? And I think over a couple of months, they interviewed something like 7,000 children. Mm-hmm. And I made it by the skin of my teeth. I was the last one to be chosen, the 24th Mouseketeer.
That's a lot of backstage mothers.
Oh, yes. Oh my.
How many Jack Gilardi's happy, by the way, that you were chosen.
That's Annette's husband.
That's her husband.
Nice man. How many Mouseketeers were there, did you say, 20?
There were 24 Mouseketeers.
24.
Yes, they put us into three groups, the red, white, and blue. And the red group... with the kids that opened and closed the show every day. We did the roll call and the now it's time to say goodbye. So we became the most familiar with the audience.
Why don't we kind of get in the mood by putting on our hats?
Oh.
Shall we? We have the hats.
Oh, it's got a ribbon on it.
I've been waiting all week because I don't have any ears.
You know, what's interesting is that you start a whole new generation. My four children... just love Mickey
Irish
Mouse. They watch it all the time.
Really?
Isn't that interesting? And as a kid, I watched it.
Mine has collapsed.
No, you have
not my head, the hat.
How about
my head? My wife.
Oh, thank you, boys. Thank you.
Oh, you got to be kidding.
Look at the boys in the band. Oh. Thank you, boys.
Oh, terrific.
That's very nice.
No,
Joe.
Look so
a little
handsome.
Further back.
We're going. I can't keep
no
this
over
thing
your
on
face, Joe.
I can't keep this thing on. If it ever gets stuck to the hairspray, I'll never be able to take it off. We're going to have something of a Mouseka reunion right here at Walt Disney World. So let's turn back the clock a few years and meet the Mouseketeers back in the mid 50s.
Good idea.
Watch.
Mouseketeers, roll call. Count off now.
Karen. Cubby. Doreen.
Wally.
Darlene.
Dennis.
Cheryl.
JJ.
Annette.
Tommy.
Sharon.
Bobby.
Roy.
Jimmy.
Cheers for the merry Mouseketeers. Mouseketeers!
And now let's meet some of those same Mouseketeers in 1976. Here's Bobby. This young man made his debut on the Mickey Mouse Club at age 14. He was an expert dancer at that age. For the past 15 years, he's been a familiar face to TV viewers as a regular on the Lawrence Welk Show. In fact, he's married to accordionist Myron Florin's daughter. Here is Bobby Burgess. Yeah, Bobby. Welcome.
And now, here's Tommy. And this young man auditioned for the Mickey Mouse Club as an accordionist. But he got the job because of his singing. And he and Bobby Burgess were always having contests on the set to see who had the tallest pompadour haircut. He's now married and works as a makeup man in Hollywood. Here's Tommy Cole.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's Cubby. Come on out, Cubby. Walt Disney spotted this young man on a television show drumming out a beat on a set of ash cans and cola boxes. Since then, he has performed with Carol Burnett and John Davidson. Currently, records with two of my favorite people, Karen and Richard Carpenter. Here's Cubby O'Brien.
Cubby.
Yeah, Cubby. And here's Darlene. Finally, this lady was a freckle-faced kid of 14 when Walt Disney saw her dance and signed her for the Mickey Mouse Club. Since that time, she's acted on television and on the stage, studied nursing, and became a specialist in cardiac disorders, has recently turned in a new career in country and western. Please welcome Darlene Gillespie.
Now that we have all of you here, and we're all in the right kind of a mood, and we've got such a great audience out here, would you all be... How about the audience asking questions? Is it all right with all of you?
Sure. Great, sure.
Now, may I ask you please to first identify yourself, and if you will, tell us where you're from.
Rudy Hernandez from Tampa, and I'd like to ask Annette a question. Is it true that Frankie Avalon introduced you to your husband?
Yes, that is true. I was dating Frankie Avalon, and my husband, Jack Gilardi, was Frankie's agent, and we met that way, and now Jack Gilardi is also my agent.
Your name, please, and where you're from.
My name is Bruce Long from Kissimmee, Florida. I have a question for Tommy.
For Tommy?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Didn't you and Darlene have a hit record together? What was it, and could you do a little of it for us now?
Well, we had a couple. One was called Do Me So Do, and the other one was I Am Not Now, Never Been in Love. But Do Me So Do is one we...
Oh, that so was a biggie.
Yeah, it was a biggie.
Yeah.
Back then, it was a biggie.
My mother bought it.
You can do some of it now?
Yeah.
Mary, Mary, quite contrary, sat upon a lonesome prairie, waiting for someone to sing this song.
Soon a horn blew, Mary knew that it was boy blue, and he'd do to sing with her this happy little song. Oh, sing.
Do me so do.
I love to sing.
Re fa so la,
ti do re do, ti la so fa mi re do.
Do mi so do.
I love to sing.
Re fa so la.
Ti do re do ti la so fa mi re do.
That's good.
Thank you.
Josh Moore from Walt Disney World, Miss Munch, Anita, and Annette Funicello.
This glass was washed with a leading dishwasher detergent. Look spotless? Look again. No dishwasher detergent can prevent water spots. Another glass was washed with the same detergent and Jet-Dry Water Spot Preventer. Jet-Dry works in the rinse cycle where spots begin. Your detergent is already down the drain. Jet-Dry makes rinse water sheet off without leaving drops. Leaves glasses clean and clear. Get Jet-Dry. Lasts 2 months in normal use.
7-Up the Uncola salutes the bicentennial with 76 holidays in history. Win one of 38 trips for two along the Freedom Trail from Boston to Washington. You'll fly Allegheny Airlines, America's sixth largest passenger carrier, and stay at Marriott Hotels. 7,600 prizes in all. Win two ways. Collect all 8 presidential likenesses under 7-Up bottle caps, or find an instant winner cap and win immediately. Details and entry blanks at your 7-Up dealer. All prizes awarded. 76 holidays in history closes April 30th. Void where prohibited.
Well, he was the kind of a governor who, when he saw a problem that everyone else had given up on and said it couldn't be done, he faced it head-on, even after maybe other governors and the rest of the nation had given up.
For example, he reduced California welfare rolls by 300,000, yet increased benefits to the truly needy by an average of 43%.
In spite of a growing population, he kept the size of state government virtually the same. He enlisted the aid of private citizens to help him find solutions to California's problems. He obtained substantial tax relief for property owners, renters, and senior citizens.
During his administration, state support of education increased dramatically, making possible cuts in local tax rates. As governor of our most populous state, he proved that problems can be solved below the federal level at substantial savings to the taxpayers.
He was that kind of governor. He'll be that kind of president. Reagan, he'll provide the strong new leadership America needs.
did you and Darlene fight all the time? About what?
Silly things.
I think because we were both sopranos.
Yeah, I think, well, I've
changed a little bit. Oh.
Really?
Well, we were both picked as singers. I wasn't a dancer when I started the show. And there may have been a little jealousy there. I'm not sure.
Heavens no, Tom. Nothing like that. He just sang better than I did.
We have time for one more question? I'd like to ask Cubby a question, if I may. When Dean introduced you, he said that you played a set of ash cans and cola boxes.
I had a feeling you were going to ask me about that.
You still do that?
Well, I brought my bronzed ash cans in, and I thought that maybe we could bring them out. Could you guys bring them out, and maybe I'll
bronze
demonstrate
ash cans?
Well, I'll demonstrate how I got started in show business. Thank you.
Hey, let's have a hand for Lou Cesarone, the Philadelphia Flash, right here. I'll say a word to the folks at home, Lou. Say a word to the folks at home.
All right.
You can put that cue card down now for you, for Lou.
I want to explain it real quickly. When I first started playing drums, my dad is a drummer and started giving me lessons. And the reason he gave me lessons was because I built a little drum set out in the backyard. I had a pots and pans, and I went out and started banging around on them and knives and forks. And he said, well, I think he's ready for lessons, you know. So my whole life, my whole show business career really started with junk, you know, trash cans and ash cans and all that kind of stuff. So let me give you a little demonstration here.
Okay, Cubby. He doesn't need a microphone. This is going to make more noise. A microphone.
Am I in your way?
I remember that story after your first job when you came home and you had that sad story you told your mother. She said, how did it go? And you said, not too well, I got canned. All that way for that one rotten... May I have another question, please? Thank you, boys. May I have another?
My name's Tina Sinkinson, and I'd like to ask Annette...
Excuse me, where are you from? Nome, Alaska?
From Orlando.
From Orlando, oh.
I wish I had that hat on. It's darling.
Go ahead.
I'd like to ask Annette if she remembers any of the songs from the Talent Roundup.
From the Talent Roundup? Oh, you know, that was the name of the Friday show that we did. Friday was Talent Roundup Day. Each day had a different name for the opening. Monday was Fun with Music Day. Right. Tuesday was Guest Star Day.
But Wednesday, the talent happened.
Yeah, Thursday Wednesday, was Circus
excuse
Day.
Excuse me, Wednesday what?
Anything can happen. Thursday was Circus Day. Friday was my very favorite day. That was like a little Western show that we did. That was Talent Roundup Day.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Oh! Saddle your ponies, here we go, down to the talent rodeo. Gather up Susie, Jack, and Joe, join the talent roundup. Round them up,
bring them in, everybody's sure to win. Step right up, here we go, oh, what a rodeo. Gather up Dinah, Bob, and Bill, ask everybody on the hill. We're gonna have a great big thrill, join the talent roundup.
Terrific.
We remembered the song. Wow.
Sort of. Your name, please.
Bonnie Ingram.
Where are you from?
Kissimmee.
Pardon?
Kissimmee.
Oh.
She was from England.
Do you think there'll ever be another Mouseketeer show, a new one?
Do we think there'll ever be another Mouseketeer
show?
Well, there is going to be one.
A new one?
There's one scheduled for next year, 77, I think, in January.
Right.
And they're casting new kids right now.
Right, yeah. As a matter of fact, they're sending out the talent scouts, the Disney studio, and they're looking all through the United States. They're going to start with a group this time of 9 instead of the 24 like we had. And it'll be done very much the same as our show, only updated, much more contemporary as far as music and...
Where can we audition? Go.
Yes, I was just going to audition.
Yeah, I was wondering, is the talent search happening now? Because people around the country are going to write me about it now since we mentioned it.
Yes, they're starting it right now because they're going to be filming in the summertime.
Mm-hmm.
So they are starting auditions.
Will it take the place of the old show?
Is it one of ours?
Yes. Yes, it will take the place of the old show.
Okay. We have time for just one more question, young man.
My name's Paul Hicks. The question's for all of them. I would like to know if you would sing the mouse cartoon for us all, please.
Time to twist our mouseketeer to the right and the left with a great big smile. This is the way we get to see a mouse cartoon for you and me. Miska, Muska, Mouseketeer. Mouse cartoon sometime is here.
Miska, Muska, Mouseketeer. Time for a commercial now is here.
Stay tuned. There's more mouse from the Mouse Kingdom.
Do you have anything for headaches?
Yes, take two of these.
Arthritis pain formula. I have a headache, not arthritis.
Doesn't matter. Arthritis pain formula is great for occasional headaches, too. Look at the label.
Also relieves headaches. Must be strong.
You bet it is. APF has more pain reliever in it than most headache tablets. Arthritis pain formula.
Hey, thanks. Arthritis pain formula is great for headaches.
Arthritis pain formula. Great for headaches, too.
Hi, I'm Eve Arden's daughter, Connie. Mom here has promised not to say a word while I tell you about new Light Blend Imperial. It's a marvelous new spread that's different from butter or margarine because it's made with less oil. Mmm, it tastes light, fresh, sort of delicate. Now there's Light Blend Imperial for people with a liking for lightness, like me.
And regular Imperial for butter lovers like me.
Mom.
Sorry.
Sunday is George Washington's birthday, so why not celebrate with a traditionally American meal like Jewel Pot Roast? Through Saturday at Jewel, beef play pot roast is just 56 cents a pound. And for more great American eating, you'll want to stock up during Jewel's Spirit of 76 sale. You'll find exciting values like 4 16-ounce loaves of Belmont bread for just 76 cents. So don't miss the Spirit of 76 sale through Saturday at Jewel.
I'm Henry Block of H&R Block. This year, there are major changes in the income tax laws that can affect how you file, what you can deduct, how much you owe. That's why my reason number 12 is so important. Our tax preparers are specially trained to help you take full advantage of these new laws. We'll do our best to see that you pay the right amount of tax.
200 convenient area offices, including most Sears stores. Join the fun fair of St. John's Lutheran School PTA League tomorrow, 10 to 3, 47th and Brainerd LaGrange. Games, white elephant sale, and refreshments included.
Are you having fun out there? Are you enjoying it? This is a very special group of people here, in my eyes. On our show, if you've ever seen our show, we normally sit down like this at the end of the show, and everybody who has been a part of that 90-minute show has to do something. So I'll start it off, and I'd like your help, Dean and Anita, if you will, on this.
What do you want us to do?
I need a whistle on this.
A whistle?
Yes. Can you both
whistle? We flew in 3,000 miles to whistle?
Right.
Okay, Mike. For you, anything.
Okay, thank you.
I'm freezing to death. I want to get this over with.
Shh. Oh, I got you. Just whistle while you work. Put on that grin and start right into whistle loud and long. Just hum a merry tune. Just do your best and take a rest and sing yourself a song. When there's too much to do, don't let it bother you.
That's right.
Forget your troubles, try to be just like a cheerful chickadee.
Yes.
And whistle while you work. Come on, get smart, tune up and start and whistle while you work. Bobby and Cubby.
Wonderful.
Bobby and Cubby. You're going to do
Bobby
something?
Bobby and Cubby.
Yes.
You know, Cubby and I were always kind of in competition because we were both into rhythm. I was tap dancing and he was playing drums. But everybody always said he was a better drummer than I was a dancer.
No, no. You're a better dancer than I was a drummer.
No, you're a better drummer.
No, you're with Lawrence Welk. And...
you're with the Carpenters. You lead the band. You drum. Why don't we have a little challenge and settle this argument
once
and for all. Okay, get back on the drums, okay? Ready, boys?
One and two.
Beautiful, Bobby. Lovely.
That'll be a tie.
Let me tell you, Cubby's been practicing his tap dancing. I would like to show you a couple steps together. Days.
You know, I just have to say this, Mike. I that's one of the most incredible things I've ever seen.
You know, it really is. I've never. He dances so great, and he plays
drums. No. I'm not talking about the dancing and the drums. Their hats didn't fall off.
Because they're pinned on. Yeah.
One of they turned secrets. On. Your hats have, turned on.
A couple of bobby pins.
Oh, pinned on. Oh.
You don't understand. Those aren't hats. Oh, no, those are the real ears. Darlene, it's your turn, my dear.
Oh, thank you.
Ballads have always been my favorite, so I'm going to try one of them. This is from West Side Story.
There's a place for us, somewhere a place for us, peace and quiet and open air, wait for us somewhere.
He calls me Pineapple Princess all day as he plays his ukulele on the hill above the bay. Pineapple Princess, I love you, you're the cutest.
I've seen. Someday we're gonna marry and you'll be my pineapple queen.
I know there's a special way that you used to close the Mickey Mouse Club. How about closing this segment by doing it again, okay? And here he is himself, Mickey Mouse. Everyone join in. Here he is himself. Soon. Why? Because we like you. Thank you, Annette.
I thought to sit and Walt Disney World at night.
Mazzola says...